he needs to have you at arm's length. And he'll send out his sand soldier and he'll try to get a Thunderlord's proc onto you. But if you relentless pursuit under...
Not how this one goes.
I understand that you're trying to help me, but you're just making me sad.
Yeah, you're just making things worse. Because Becco takes a lot of damage here.
He has to go all in.
He is going to answer.
Oh, he's lost.
Yeah, he looks for it here as Swift. He's going to dance his way over. Yeah, gets over the wall, is able to pick up the kill. Nicely done from Swift. Good positioning, and Shiye a little bit over-aggressive as there's the flash from Vic. Probably wanting to elongate this lane phase as much as possible. As you can see Uzi and Moore still battling here, but Moore in a whole host of trouble. Mystic actually getting flash forward using that arcane shift, and there's the last auto attack after the flash, and Moore, unfortunately, unable to make that one work. Zero actually looking for this. There's the flash forward. Does have the last auto as Uzi's actually trying to make this a 1-for-2. He is going to come in there as the teleport is a little bit earlier there from Pekko, 957. Now he's going to get the flash, but doesn't quite get the stun against the wall. Sand Soldier going to come over the top, and GA going to lock down the kills. Now Pekko 1 versus 3, but does have a lot of damage. Serrated Dirk actually picked up. That is going to be his mid lane adaptation. Five members on the bottom side of the map here for WE. The Culling is going to fly through. Pekko cancels it embarrassingly,
no.
And there's the exhaust. Uses the Emperor's Divide there as well. Shiye just seems to have control over Pekko right now. The last auto attack's gonna do it. Shiye.
Time frame where they can really execute on this, because certainly QG will be sending members back. Here from Swift.
Yeah, Swift is gonna make his way in, but not able to answer that one. The Rift Heralded minions doing a little bit too much work, but there are the pings going down.
No.
As Shiye actually looking for V. The exhaust goes down as he tries to catch up, but just can't do it. Swift is gonna make his way in. Emperor's Divide is actually gonna get dodged by the Twisted Advance. Shiye with a rare misplay. Is going to pay the price.
Far too aggressive right there, and now QG continuing the chase.
Yeah, Condi actually uses the collateral damage to create some distance, but I have a feeling this Graves is not long for the world. Uzi just throws a boomerang at him. Yeah, and he's gone for his karma here as well. As Swift is going to be discovered here by Zero. Moore can't quite get over the top there as the W was down there from 957. V is going to make his way in as well, but WE are collapsing really nicely. The Culling is going to fly through from Pekko as he's in a safe position, but Zero going to fail the flash. Still going to survive as Lance's fight comes in. Mystic on top of it now as well. Who's going to be able to pick up the kill? Pekko is going to be able to grab it after that one wears off, and Swift survives. Uzi now hunting for members of WE.
We're speeding up everyone else as happening in the mid lane.
Yeah, GA in a whole host of trouble. Zero's trying to peel for him there as the Emperor's Divide comes in. GA just going to get flashed on though by Swift, who picks up the kill, and Condi now running for the hills. Uzi with a nice auto attack reset is going to get the concussive blows, but Condi deceptively tanky right now as Moore in a whole host of trouble. Does use the Lance Respite though, and Swift able to get some damage across as Mystic throws out the True Shot Barrage. Fantastic spell shield from Uzi is going to keep him alive as Pekko. So aggressive, V's able to pick it up with a Twisted Advance, and W able to get a whole bunch of his health back. And if multiple AD carries can do anything, it's take down neutral objectives really quickly. But 957 wants to be able to try and get in here. Throws down the ultimate, gets rid of a couple of them.
Smite.
Definitely the smite there as Condi's going to come in, doing what he does best, which is steal Baron or just kill everyone. They get straight back on the Baron as Pekko is actually trying to hang out over the top here. Swift has been able to make his way back over. The WE, they of course respawn. Now everyone battling for this Baron. Pekko makes his way
Baron
over as well.
Shiye
is going to be able to take down Pekko. Massive damage here as WE cleaning up. They love the Baron fights and they're able to do it one more time. But the Baron is able to be picked up by QG despite the ace.
Okay, Baron is picked up, so you get the global.
Not so much anymore as WE looking to try and take down Pekko. There's the headbutt. The pulverize comes in as well. Nicely timed as he's trying to run away, but
nice.
Nothing doing.
Just really beautiful CC chain from Zero to make sure that he didn't... hold on.
Yeah, actually, there's the wallbang as well under Swift. He will have to use the Lamb's Respite most likely. Actually, dances out of the way, does still have it, and puts it down now. But he will be moving out of the way. The Sand Soldiers are going to be there, and 957 picks up another one. Massive picks all across the board. Uzi now fighting with WE, flashes out of the way. Really good positioning here from the AD carry behind his tank line, but 957 hunting now for the Sivir. There's the wallbang. This pop is so big. My god, GA is going to knock away V. Now caught in the red pit is Moore. One more auto attack from GA is going to do it. And WE have torn this game in half. V now the last man standing. Condi kiting out of the way. How did this even happen?
Disaster for QG. He's going to go over the wall and he's going to attempt to steal it with Smite and then ult himself back over. No.
He's just going to take it as the teleport's coming in from QG. Swift has to use the Lance Respite, buying some time for the teleport here as V's made his way in. He's just going to immediately try and disengage those. Condi over the top, takes down Swift. Now Uzi has to deal with this. Graves is just dashing on top of him. Massive damage comes in as V now just going to seclude himself from this fight. GA, gigantic Ember's Divide is going to get rid of Uzi, and that is so much consistent damage dead. WE just orchestrating these team fights so wonderfully. and Moore is going to complete the ace. WE could go for Baron, they could go for the win. This team looks so good.
They're rotating towards the top lane where they have the massive creep wave, so death timers, super punishing from QG. I believe the latest one, or the earliest one, is going to be 33 seconds and 20 seconds on Swift and Moore, respectively.
And that's a Thornmail done here for 957 as well. There is no way that he's dying to anything. I don't even think a turret can scratch him, as this inhibitor
this
is going
game.
To fall down. This most definitely is going to be game, as Zero's going to tank up the turret. Nexus turrets are falling here as well. All five members of WE bearing down on the second Nexus of this best of five series. This third place looking definitely under fire from WE, and a fantastic play in this game number two.
And reminder that QG actually have the superior